Well, by the court's unanimous decision, the court being me, I have decided that the GT is going to have 3 medium lift blades on it. So it will do a better job of blowing the leaves off driveways and stuff. So there's one. And there, you can see them, the other two. Let's see if I can turn this one. Yep. So, that's the decision I've come up with, because the gator blades over there, they do great, but they do not give you the throw out that you would like the mower to have. But it also depends on the engine speed. So the faster the engine turns, the more the PTO, especially the electric style, rotates. The faster it rotates, the faster the blades rotate. But also, you gotta think about your belts. Make sure that the belts are in good condition, and that all the V groove pulleys and the eyelet pulleys that go on the flat side of the blade belt are in working order. There's no, there's this thickness they're supposed to be when they're brand new and all that other good stuff. Now, it's a whole different ball game when you are using more such as that one over there. That's manual blade engagement. The belt is not under tension all the time. But with this one, it has a certain amount of tension on it at all times. Just make sure that you, when going to replace this belt, or even this belt, because this is a double belt system. Now, I want to put another kind of mower pan on here, let's say a 54 inch that has a better opening than this, because this is a great mower pan, but I like to be able to damn also put a mower plug like what's on my GT, my XT over there. Be able to damn mower leaves with it. But all this is good for is now separating leaves on property lines and mowing up concrete and asphalt driveways and even a gravel driveway like what I live at. But, and I'm going to do a little test using this tool. I'm going to, I don't know how to really read this thing, but I'm going to test the blade airflow on this mower at engagement speed and full throttle. See how fast the air is coming out of this opening. But I also got to determine how far away from this mower pan this has to be, and that which way does it need to face. Talking to determine the MPH. A lot of people say, oh, MPH don't mean nothing on a blower, on a mower's output. Well, I tell y'all people, but it all depends on the type of blades and stuff. I like, you know, I just say this, I have OCD when it comes to mower output. I like to damn cut the grass, get what I've cut way out of the way. But, you know, you got to take into consideration the type of grass, how much of the pan you're using. Because when you first start cutting grass in certain areas, yes, you're going to be full lap. Well, full lap, full mower pan. Then after that, you can do half, 75%, one half, you know. The percentage is up to you as to how much of the cutting of the next row of grass you want to cut. But, like I said, now, I'm going to test this out, and I'll be able to make a video of it. It's going to be a little loud, because like I said, my girl, she's dual overhead valve. But I had to re-record this video because I thought I had it recorded earlier, but unfortunately not. So See you later, peoples. Hasta la vista, babies.